Welcome to the Coupler.io Academy, where industry experts share tips and tricks on working with data. In this video, we will teach you how to use a pivot table in Looker Studio. Hi there, my name's Annie. Pivot tables are extremely popular among analysts and virtually anyone working with data. They provide tons of insights, can be customized in a number of ways, and set up within seconds. So how about I show you how to create a pivot table in Looker Studio? I have an empty Looker Studio report. I previously used Coupler.io to connect and blend data from several advertising platforms such as Facebook or Google Ads. You can see the imported fields in the data pane to the right. You can add a new pivot table through the Add a Chart menu. Three types of pivot tables are available: a standard table, one with bars, and another with a heat map. Let's go with the classic version. I'll drop it here and expand. A Looker Studio pivot table has three standard elements. Row dimensions control the rows of a table. Column dimensions are in charge of the columns of a pivot table. Finally, metrics determine what data appears inside the table. Looker Studio tried to build a meaningful pivot table for me, but the result doesn't quite live up to expectations. So let's change it right away. As the row dimension, I'll select the source column, which represents the channel a campaign ran on. You'll see the four platforms appearing in the dataset to the left now. I also want to aggregate the campaigns by their start date, so I'll set this field as a column dimension. As you can see, you can either pick the field from the drop-down or drag and drop it into the chosen area. Aggregating ID numbers doesn't really make sense, so let's also swap the metric used in the pivot table. I'll go with total clicks and remove the previous selection. The table is starting to look a bit better now, but there's still work to do. Let's now talk about how to customize a pivot table in Looker Studio. When you aggregate by dates, it rarely makes sense to see the numbers for each day. It's common to group dates by weeks, months, quarters, and so on. Clicking the icon to the left from the date field lets you choose the type of grouping that makes the most sense for you. In my case, grouping by year and month seems to be just the right fit. Pivot tables in Looker Studio accept multiple dimensions and metrics. For example, I can add the campaign name field as a row dimension, which will give me a nice breakdown of campaigns that ran on each platform and the clicks they generated every month. When you have multiple row dimensions, an option to expand and collapse becomes handy. It creates a button in the top right corner that users can click to swap between views. Using the respective menu, you can decide on the default view. In the same way, you can add more metrics up until the limit of 20. I also want to see the number of impressions of my campaigns. As I expand, I'll see both metrics for each campaign I ran. You can also customize each of your metrics. Give it a custom name if you'd like, change the type of data if you're, for example, dealing with percentages or currencies. Finally, change the aggregation method to the one that's the most meaningful. Let's try to get the average number of impressions. Ah, and I got an error. Brilliant. As you work with pivot tables, you'll see these kinds of errors every now and then. They don't usually mean that you did something wrong. Unfortunately, Looker Studio pivot tables have been quite buggy for a long time, and it doesn't look like there's a quick fix on the horizon. There's no one scenario where errors will always appear. As a matter of fact, I may try to get the average number of impressions tomorrow, and it may work just fine. But for some reason, averages may haunt you more often than the other aggregation methods will. In my experience, pivot tables also tend to crash way too often when you skip either row or column dimension in your table, or when you enable the expand collapse feature I showed you moments ago. Now, this is not to say that you should avoid all three scenarios, but if the errors become too much of an issue, consider using a regular table instead. They might lack the features of a pivot table, but they do make up for it with reliability. Okay, let's try something less controversial here and choose the maximum value for each campaign in a given month. You can also add optional metrics. For example, the reach field. Optional metrics are available for users of a report who can add them to their view if they want. For the sake of simplicity, let's remove this metric for now. Looker Studio tends to be lazy to remove it itself, and you may need to refresh the page to get rid of outdated data. In the meantime, I've also removed the impressions metric, as it's far easier to show certain behaviors with just a single metric. Pivot tables in Looker Studio let you also see the totals for both rows and columns. You can also apply custom sorting. The source field contains text values, so sorting by that field will just order the platforms alphabetically. You can also order by a metric, which will take the total number of clicks for each platform and sort it into a descending order. If you use more than one row dimension, apply further sorting for these values too. It's the same for the columns. Sort them by the field used as a column dimension, which often makes sense for dates, but consider also sorting by the metric again, which will order the columns by the number of clicks they have accumulated. By default, Looker Studio pivot tables use an auto date range, which means they return data based on a date control on a page, if any, or the report settings. You can opt to use a custom date range instead, either picking fixed dates or choosing from a number of presets. What's more, you can filter the data that appears on your pivot table. Click to add a filter, and let's say include only campaigns that have more than 10,000 impressions. As with any other chart, you can also customize a pivot table using the Style tab. For example, I can apply conditional formatting to my data. I'll choose the color scale and the formatting based on the metric used in my table, total clicks. You can update the size of headers, change their background color, and so on. Another useful customization is choosing how the missing data should be represented. Let's try a no data label. By the way, if you are new to Looker Studio, we've recently released a detailed getting started tutorial that you may find really useful. Check the link in the corner of your screen. And that's it. Now you know how to use a pivot table in Looker Studio. But if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like, share the video with others, and subscribe to our channel so you never miss a thing. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.